Prayer is relationship with God. Prayer is union with God. Prayer is intimate relationship with himself. Prayer is a friendly, frequent conversation with Him who has first loved us. Pag-istudya sa tao na ang higala, kanina ay pag-istudya kanina ang kanina ang pag-ugresya, unang nakibuma at panalo. This is how St. Teresa will define prayer and the Church will call it contemplative prayer. Pag-istudya, this is where the weakness of the grace of God in prayer lies. Pag-alagang ako, pag-alagang na natin na ang kahapon prayer is a means, prayer is a method para makaabutan ako sa Diyo. Prayer is a method in order to communicate God. Sa pagkakataon, we believe that prayer is an activity in order to reach God. We have to make some address. For St. Teresa, prayer is not a method. Prayer is a relationship. First, it is friendship with God. Contemplative prayer is simply the God. In other words, for St. Teresa, prayer is at the means. Prayer is rather the end. Kung nakaampo na yan ka, matangang kaayos na sa iyo. Kung nakaampo na yan ka, kailangan mo pati matay, nakikusa na sa iyo. Hindi lang nakaupo sa iyo, nakikusa na sa iyo. In other words, St. Teresa, for St. Teresa, prayer is a good. In the words of Pope Francis, he says, prayer, an act of faith, is full. An encounter with the living God who calls us and gives his love, a love that receives us, and upon which we can learn greatly for security and for living our lives. It is this kind of encounter with God in prayer that will transform us. It is this kind of prayer, contemplative prayer, that will lead us. Okay, so that great picture that she is, St. Teresa gives us specific instructions so that we can really pray. And we can say, contemplative prayer, about God. Contemplative prayer, by God. Contemplative prayer, mag-usapan sa Yahweh. So, kapag-usapan na, usapan na, that will facilitate contemplative prayer. We will say, deep is pain. Detachment, humility, and love. We will say, kapiling puro. So, hindi na hanggang tayo para sa tao, makakampo sa ginagawa ng contemplative prayer. Kung sa pangyayari, say, kung sa detachment, humility, and love.
Kung dahil kayo ang karawanan, kung yan ang pangyong grupo,
love, humility, detachment, humility, and love. Brothers and sisters, St. Teresa teaches us that these three virtues of detachment, humility, and love for others can assist us and prepare our hearts for the gift of contemplative prayer. And why is contemplative prayer important? Because when we look at contemplative prayer, we did not come in the heart in the book of the Romans, letter of the Romans, and the Spirit of Jesus and Mabolo. Therefore, contemplative prayer is in fact the action of God in the human heart. Contemplative prayer, therefore, is a spirit. It means that we are not done. Contemplative prayer is about what we give from God. It is God's love given to us. From the life of the example of St. Teresa, we realize that prayer, contemplative prayer, is the way to human. Renewal in the end is not simply in a project. Because renewal and change of heart is not simply something that I desire. In a hand of the Ayuba, how you living that is about you. There is a learning in the hand, it is the word. All renewal, authentic renewal, is always founded on prayer, which is encountered with the love of Jesus, the crucified and risen one. To encounter God is to be transformed by God. The living powers of the Teresa, the Son of the Cross. Why do you use that? Pakahimang pakalikas ng buko, pagkukulong na sila, makuntan na nila sa buko, to be transformed, to be now by God, is to be transformed by God, just as in the same manner to be now by God, is to be healed by God. That is why we say, prayer has power. Brothers and sisters, talk about that. I believe that the beauty of these things that we can be God by God and the Lord in Santa Teresa, and we can hope. Saan na ako sa mga pagsuko sinasama. Masinasama ang mga pagkakos sa kaibigan na anak. Itong na ako sa Baba, let prepares us for this. Panahon sa kawisa, panahon sa pagkakos sa kasikasin, ang ako pag-ibo ng ako pag-alilong lipa, may pagkakos sa pasko sa pagkawa na ako. Kung sabi na ako sa surta, Easter is a time of renewal. During Easter, we renew the vows we made in baptism. During Easter, we renew our commitment to shape and live our lives after the example of Jesus, the crucified and risen one. Kung sa kaya na ako sa Santa Teresa, ako din naman ni Santa Teresa. Siya kaya ang ulo. Eventually, siya ay hindi ko ulo sa mga pagulong sa kabaluhan na siya. Pinaaki sa kaya ng hindi ko pagulungan. She becomes a tuning and reformer and a founder. Siya'y pagkailawag na usa sa mga halimbing simbahan niya sa mga pangko sa pinamuling simbahan. And for the mother and the teacher of this, Teresa continues to teach us and lead us back to the role of renewal and commitment. Today, on our 500th birthday, St. Teresa wants to recognize us. So that we can better reward you and commit ourselves to working with Jesus and to working for Jesus so that God's kingdom may be established among us. Brothers and sisters, the birthday of St. Teresa is a day of grace. Let us ask the Lord to grant us the gift of contemplative prayer. Let St. Teresa may be comforted and recognize the mother of God as we hold the events of daily life. Let St. Teresa may learn how to walk in the way of true humility, learn to be truly free from things, people to be guided by these practices, and may be able to have our sensitive and compassionate power. Saint Teresa, our Holy Mother, may we still use the power of God and the wisdom of God as we move on to the situations and challenges that would require us to make decisions in life. Most of all, we pray, Santa Teresa, may we discover the presence of God and experience the love of God who dwells in the heart of every person. Father, Santa Teresa,